How far are you along? How many songs have you done?
We've got another month from, like, just saying, well, this is it, we're finished.
Oh, really?
I'll wrap
so
it up.
We'll give us another month.
When I listened to the first album, right, I knew it was your first album. Everything was raw, and it was this. And then you came with that next motherfucker with the feeling, where, okay, they done perfected some shit.
Exactly.
Y'all
that's
was
when
like,
we really started feeling ourselves.
Y'all was that. Like, let me step back.
You must have at least a target month or season.
Well, should we tell him a month?
Look for a single in August.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
It's not all that, though. It's just right, you know.
Just a little something.
It's a little something.
Just a little something. Just a little something.
I was singing once again, and I just felt like just doing that, and you know, it wasn't nothing planned in it.
JoJo, I mean, carry that high note.
I say whatever you need.
Why did their harmony sound like it was 20 people?
Well, first of all, I knew the secret behind that.
Like
because
20 people.
Devontae had them stacking them vocals.
So, okay.
Yeah, you know how you you may do three of one note. Oh, nah, it was like eight on one note. But the thing, too, is because Devontae played keyboard, he was able to make them do notes that people don't regularly hear.
Okay.
So that's what it
was. That's what it was. But the way they blended it, I've never heard that note. And how does that note work with all of this?
Because we only hear alto, soprano, and tenor. But when you're playing on the keyboards, he knew those in-between notes.
What's the thought process between you guys going into that record? Because you're under pressure now. You had a hit album.
Really, well, it was a lot easier because we was having fun doing it. It just took a little longer to make because everybody was just, you know, enjoying the long touring process of the first album and, you know, all the promotional and everything. So going into this one was just a lot easier.
It's like continuation of the first album, you know? It's like you just, because a lot of the songs that we are doing supposed to have, it's like you was going to put them on a first album. We didn't, so we saved it to the second album, and you kind of got the same feel.
Right. You know, so I have to let you know, I am so proud of you four country boys.
Oh!
You just came up. Well, let me ask you this, all four of you. How come every time you get on stage, you got to come out your clothes?
Because it gets hot.
And back to women, what's this about these rape charges that I hear as between Devontae and Casey? What's that whole hoop?
Allegations are false.
Recently, it's been in the news.
Exactly.
Now, you know, reports of a rape.
There's always going to be somebody that want to bring you down, no matter how much good you do.
Allegations are definitely false, and we just got to take care of it.
Wasn't no sexual activity. Wasn't no touching or nothing.
Well, clear up the rumor right now, because what I've heard, and I'm sure that everybody else has heard, we've read everywhere that you two have been charged with rape.
It's not even a rape charge.
Papers has a rape charge, not a rape charge.
I guess she wanted attention.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess she just, I don't know, she just bugging, I guess. You know, we don't know why that could happen to anybody.
They threw my surprise birthday party. Was working on Let's Be Alone. Was waiting on Devontae, waiting. It started getting late. And everybody in the studio waiting on Devontae. We kept calling. And it was like, something ain't right, man. He just wouldn't not show up or come to the studio or something. So our manager called the studio. Was like, now everybody get to Devontae's house. They broke in his house, tried to kill him, tied him up. Man, he was fighting back. He bit one of the guy's fingers off.
We've been getting all kind of media press and everything. I just like to say, don't believe everything you read.
Right.
Well, what is it about me and Casey? You don't believe everything you read. And everything you see on the news. You heard I got robbed. That's true. I don't believe that.
I feel worthless. I'm living on the edge.
It's been an hour since you've been gone. And that's too long, so come back home. I can't live.
It was just a nice song. I like the video. I like the whole concept of the song. Oh my God, it was in Death Valley. It's like 160 something degrees out there.
Sorry that
so heavy. It was, you know what I mean? There was so, what was special about the production?
I mean, it's the vocals and the chord changes and how we just approach songs.
I think it's a kind of newer sound, basically, but it's more the same. Ballads. Yeah.
Guys, like the whole begging for pussy thing. You guys were the best at it.
Hold on. We only begged one song. That was Keith Sweat did the begging. We only begged in Cry For You. Was giving guys that didn't really have game the mouthpiece of what to say.
Okay.
Hey, you trying to get laid? Here, give the lyrics right here. That's basically what he's doing.
Doing real well, you know, being kind of like shot out over some girl, I think. I'm not sure what's up with that.
Which one, Phoenix?
Yeah.
Monty wrote that.
He co-directed the video as well.
The last time he came, he said that was his last tattoo. What made him come back for this?
I got him Phoenix.
So how was he as a director? You leading him a whole lot?
D's gonna big up as a director this year.
He's holding his own?
Definitely holding his own. We kind of like vibed and I think we're gonna get the best product that way.
Hit me. All the product in the world. Couldn't even mess with you, baby. You're the ultimate high. You know what I'm saying? KC.
Take my mind, my house and my car. For one hit of you, you can have it all, baby.
It's a totally, totally different feel for Jodeci. They're definitely working on more of a visual scale with this. And basically, we're trying to bring out the element that the album is supposed to portray, like Diary of a Madman. So it's basically based on them and their characteristics and how they're portrayed in society.
And you know that I can't.
Everybody sing this song.
You got me faded.
It's nothing major, just, you know, a girl, regular girl, feeling about a girl. That's it, you know,
it's
one
like
of those things.
Like a strong addiction.
Man, you giving this girl everything. She must be like,
Viking, right?
Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
What's coming up with the tour and everything?
We're getting that together now. We're going to go do Soul Train and, you know, Jay Leno, Arsenio, a bunch of TV shows, and then we're going like a world tour.
Starting about what, May, April?
End of June. End of June. Yeah.
$2 million sales on our new one and $2 million on our old ones, $4 million albums all together. For you.
Man. Amen. Thank you all very much. And I'm glad that I've had this so that I can share it with y'all, you know?
I got a chance to meet Mike when I was he was in the studio actually working with Devontae. And he's like, you know, every city I go to, I buy Diary of a Mad Band. I'm like, really? He says, one of my favorite albums.
Stretching out a little bit, son.
rumor has it each one of you almost got like your own like record label, stuff like that.
Devontae's a swing mob, which is an enterprise within itself, and Joe's doing his own thing too. Well, me and KC, you know, we just signed, you know, deal. We got a label called Clowning Records. You know, you get clowned on quick.
And yet y'all still flowing like this.
They're all together, yeah.
That's cool, man. That's
that
real cool.
Yeah.
Now, I understand that you guys got new management, so you're making new changes and stuff in 94.
Well, you know.
Really making new changes. Just adding on,
and fixing what's broke.
Yeah. Like when we came, it was more like we looked at it like family, so we wasn't really, because we didn't get it for the money. We just thought, we didn't know about the money until like later when we wasn't driving fancy cars and everybody was driving Benzes and we was still catching the train. And, hey, they don't look right. Mm. You know, then questions started coming up. We was young. I was 16 when Joseph came out.
This is my policy. When it comes to artists, if you feel strongly about something, you know yourself and you know your fans better than I can. You just keep arguing with me until you get your way, until I see it your way.
Mm-hmm. I mean, because these are the people who love you, and they want to know what's the lie.
No, they
what's
said
the truth.
They said we hate women, we treat women badly. They said we think it's all about us.
But now it seems like everything is just on point, 55, just smooth.
Well, I wouldn't say 100% perfect, but you know, a lot of things change, and not for the better.
Right.
But you know, we're just still keeping our heads straight and keeping focused what we gotta do in the business, and you know, we're gonna be alright.
My brother met Suge Knight.
He taught us about the business a lot.
Okay.
And although we had sold a gang of albums, there was no signs that we were more successful than we sold 100. We're fans of Snoop and Dre, and he made the connection between us and Death Row. And
you know, as they talk, he just noticed like the things wasn't right with, you know, Uptown. And he wanted to do some stuff with, you know, with Death Row artists, so he wanted to come in.
That Tupac song was popping.
The relationship with Pac, man, he was real, man. You know, he had love for us, and he loved his craft, and he was just real, man.
Love the way you activate your hips and push your ass out. Got a nickel wanting it so bad I'm about to pass out. Wanna dig you, and I can't even lie about it, baby. Just alleviate your clothes, time to fly about.
I'm JoJo. I'm Jodeci. Out here fucking around with Aaron Hall. Fucking around with Tupac bald-headed ass. Fucking around with Suge. Fucking around with my brother KC. And fucking around with these ladies right here because they fucking my shit up. That's why the video held up. Because of these ladies.
He partied so hard, Tupac had got there kind of late.
Tupac got there late.
And that was the last time we actually, God rest in peace, Pac. That was the last time I actually spoke to Pac on a Toss It Up video.
Taste as fine as gravy. The way you move that thing, you make me wanna sing. Girl, you make my bells ring.
It was crazy because I was on my way to fly to Vegas with him. And I think I was in LA. I was in New York at the time doing a Tommy Hilfiger photo shoot. And he's like, you know, come out, blah, 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 blah. And I couldn't make it. And I think he called you or something like that.
Yeah.
Pac was really cool with us. He was really, he was like, you know, like one of us, but we would never sign a Death Row or sign a Suge Knight as far as
I'm sure. Diddy hated that though, because that was like during the whole East Coast West Coast thing, kind of.
That's another whole story, yeah. Because I mean, it's like, you know, we didn't choose like to get in between that, but it just kind of threw us in because, you know, our affiliation with Puff and with Suge. But
that's the position that Jodeci took as a group, because we was cool with Suge and Puff and Big and everybody. So
it was just crazy, man. We lived that life.
There were women just lined up, like, all the way to the rooms, like, crazy. And they were, like, in line, like, waiting for, like, Twilight to open. You know how people, like, go for a movie and shit? It was motherfuckers just in line. And so I was like, what the fuck is going on? And it was one girl. I remember this one girl was just reading a book.
Like, stepping forward.
What are they waiting on? And y'all body, oh, man, you know, they waiting. And then y'all walked out and didn't speak to nobody. because y'all was on your way to the show. And I said, well, you know me, I'm goofy. What about the bitches? The girls don't look up and say, are y'all coming back or nothing? She just flipped her motherfucking page on her book and said, I'm going to wait my turn. It was amazing.
We were just the bad boys.
We were bad.
And then when I saw y'all in concert, that experience, I can go to 1,000 shows right now and not feel that experience.
Yo! Here we go!
This is the Nightly News. Our top stories tonight, the O.J. Simpson trial ends in a not guilty verdict, Quayle announces he'll run in 96, and pork belly prices plunge. But first, our top story. In an unconfirmed report out of New York this evening, the multi-platinum R&B group Jodeci is missing.
One of the greatest albums of the 1990s is
Jodeci, The Show, The After Party,
The Hotel. That album is the 90s equivalent to Tommy by The Who. It's an epic R&B opera in which the songs seg into one another.
And the opera is played with talk boxes and vocoders, by the way.
Exactly.
Yeah, this is C-Dub from The Salty Dick. For all you niggas out there in Jeeps, six folds, six trays, and Cadillacs, that heat in the trunk. I got a brand new funk for you. Four niggas from Charlotte North Cackalacky, Jodeci.
Anytime you start writing a song about freaking you.
We were in Rochester, New York, right? Devontae told me, I'm going in this room for a week. I'm going to create a song that's going to be the signature of this record, right?
Yeah.
Every time I close my eyes, I wake up feeling so horny. I can't get you out of my mind.
We went up to Rochester, New York, right? And there was a three-level studio. He got the bottom studio. Me, Timbaland, Missy, and him was only on the bottom. Every time I would come in, I would knock on the door. It would be music going on. I would not answer the door. Man.
I think we got to a point to where you always get outsiders that come in. And so the inner circle is thinner and thinner and thinner. So...
I remember one night, it got so bad. Because I should think, personally, we from church, man, we can't sing that song. I can't see myself singing that song. And Devontae Swain was like, yo, you know what? Okay, Kay, go home. But I bet you tomorrow when you come back, you're going to sing this song. Man, we from church, man. I mean, we done did for my lady. Come and talk to me. Stay fiending and all that, man. Now we talking about freaking, man. We going a little too far with this, man. You know what I'm saying?
And then he said,
trust me tomorrow.
You should know.
I'm going to tell you what he did, man. He said, trust me, KZ. When you walk here tomorrow, trust me, you're going to sing the hell out of that song. Yo, I got you to the studio that next day. Yeah. He said, go in there. He said, go in the vocal booth. Do your verse. I bet you you'll sing it today. I'm not lying, y'all. Right. I walked in the vocal booth. Yo, it was about 10, 15 butt naked ass girls in there.
Whatever you want, whatever you need. You won't be sorry, baby.
In our career, you know, we went through the women, the money, the drugs, the alcohol. And, you know, something just hit us and, you know, and said, yo, that we wasn't brought up this way, you know? Why can't we get in the studio and function as the group that God has led
us to be, you know, traveling on the dangerous highway, you know, trying to get a contract and being hungry and having that belief, everything just, we didn't feel that way anymore. We wasn't really in contact with God and spiritually to even sit down and write a song.
And our next guest are the standard by which great singing groups will probably be measured in the coming years. This is their latest single on the Uptown label entitled Love You For Life. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jodeci.
Most of the songs that's on the album wasn't even supposed to be on the album.
Promises you made me, all the things you told me.
We wrote so many songs, and a lot of songs that would go on the album that we thought would be songs that would make the album, and it didn't.
Together for eternity.
I mean, everything was just gone. And what it was, because it wasn't the hunger for the music that was missing. It was the thanks and the love and the blessing that God had given us that we slowly forgot about. We were singing all these songs and traveling, but at the same time that we was eating, we wasn't even saying our grace before we eat. So we really lost our way.
Let me show you what I could be. Could you just
has never really been like a touring artist. He works in the studio. He just like, y'all go out there and do what y'all do, you know what I'm saying? So he prefers not to tour, you know.
Okay.
He said when he's ready, he'll come out the road. When he doesn't, he doesn't.
He was sharing his musical genius with the world, and he had an idea of what he wanted his company to be, but it kind of took the focus off of us. You know, the focus was there. You know, we were the first group released off the Basement Crew, but it wasn't, the attention that was supposed to put on us wasn't all that, because his attention was spread out so much. And, you know, plans just fell through, you know. Jodeci broke up, the whole camp really broke up.
Regardless of what happened, that dude is a genius.
A genius.
By the hand, in love with you down and out.
You know, music is a revolving door, just like fashion, just like anything else. So at the time when we kind of, because we left with number one records on the radio, we just didn't just fall off and be forced out of the industry. You know, music was changing at the time.
Yeah.
And we said, you know, well, let's just take a break and let the hip-hop whole generation come. And then now there's, you know, rap and singing and auto-tune. All that had to just transpire.
But you know what? To be honest, we never really said that 97 was coming back out with an album. I think people just anticipated because we was dropping albums like every year and a half. So they just thought we was like on, the same type of, you know, regiment. But
a lot of people overdo it, overexploit it, and they overdo it until you just get tired and full of them. That's what we didn't want to do.
That's,
you know,
exactly
what I'm saying? We wanted you to appreciate us. And then it got to a point where we didn't, because people was like, okay, that's just Jodeci again. So we paused, we stopped. Okay, all this hip-hop coming in, so we about to get caught up in that rush. Okay, we gonna forget about Jodeci. So we stopped. Let you know what's the real, you have to miss it for a minute.
Jodeci is not broken up. We're not getting no new members. It's always going to be four of us.
Nobody can touch Jodeci. I'm standing to the cameras.
We love you.